Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to talk about replacing objects with other objects. So, everything works well when you use symbols, especially this kind of task. So you see, we've got all these objects, which are symbol instances, and you see they've all been rotated and also they have been scaled slightly differently. I want to replace them, so in this case I could just select them and then replace them, but we want to take a look at another function, so I'm selecting one of them, select, same symbol instance, and all of them get selected. I want to replace them with another symbol instance, which is this one here. And to do that, you can just go up here in the control panel. Control panel is window control. So you can just select it from here and go up there. You see, replaced. They've all been rotated and they've also been scaled to the same size, but they look crazy scaled. So this is the original symbol instance and they are that large. So what gives? Let's just undo that. And let's take a look at this one. So I'm going to the symbol panel and just drag that out. And you see, this has been enlarged quite a lot. And Illustrator then, when replacing them, applies the same scaling to these. And then, of course, they get crazy big. So that's what happened here. But you see, everything is happening quite well. So if you have used symbols, then you're fine. But what happens if you didn't? So let's go to the next example, which is this one here. So they are just circles. And in order to just select them, you could go again to select same and this time fill color. But then we don't have a replacement functionality. Not inside of Illustrator, that doesn't exist. What could we do? So what we could do is use a different kind of functionality. So I'm going to select this one. And then what you can do is go into Global Edit, which is in there. So I'm going to click on it. And then you see a different kind of selection. There's this outline around it. This one is still selected. And then we also have selected these around there. So that can be corrected. So let's go up here and set this to appearance. And then Illustrator only finds the ones that have the same shape and the same appearance, so color, fill color, stroke color, effects, and so on. You can also select the same sizes, but maybe you don't even want that. And then, let's do that again, like so. Then we can replace them. But what we need to do is some preparation. So what we first need to do is select this and copy it. And then select this, go into Global Edit, and you see Illustrator doesn't find all of them because Global Edit doesn't always really work. They are all circles, but it doesn't find them. Let's select this one, click on it, works slightly better. So what we could then do when replacing them is we need to place the thing from the clipboard. I could delete the green circle first, but then we would be out of it because then there's nothing more to do. You need to first paste the thing from the clipboard. Let's just do that. And we've got an error message because that is the symbol instance and Global Edit doesn't work with symbol instances. So we need to exit here. That can be deleted. And then what we need to do, I'm going to first make a copy of it and then go to Window Symbols and disconnect that. So It's just a plain group. Copy, and then go into global edit again, like so. And then we can zoom into here, paste, and you see this worked. Scale it so that it works here. Zoom out. That's nice. And then we can select the green circle. Let's zoom in. Delete it. And nice. They all got replaced, with the exception of those green ones with which for some reason Illustrator just didn't select. So when you have scaled them, then the scaling would also be applied. So global edit is quite nice when it works. The next thing is we can use scripting. There's a JavaScript that can do this replacement. The JavaScript is called FindReplace. It actually doesn't find, but it replaces. So we have to find a solution for the finding, and also we have to correct the stacking order. So let's select this one more time. It's still a symbol instance. That's great because we want to correct the document organization. So we have just circles, but we want symbols. And this is the symbol. So in order to select them, of course, we can go to select and then select same and color. But in this case, I'm just going to select them. And then let's go to window layers and check out that stacking order. And you see the zebra is up here. That's nice because the replacement object needs to be on top. The circles are somewhere down. That's okay. So let's select them all and then trigger the script. So let's go to File, Scripts, Other Script, and I have already selected it in here. And what we want to do is transform to fit so that all those replacement symbols also get transformed to the size of the original object. So let's start it, and you see, nice, they all got transformed. Great. And they are all now symbols, symbol instances. So next option that you have is use plugins. So maybe you already have the Astute Graphics plugins. And there's one that can also do find and replace. And it actually can do a quite nice find operation. So this one is a dashed stroke with a width profile. So first of all, we want to outline that. So let's go to outline stroke. And then, of course, let's ungroup that because everything else would be too simple. And again, we are going to use the zebra. So, but first, we want to do some finding in here, so finding objects. And I'm going to select one of them, and let's go to the Astute Graphics Find Replace Art. There it is. And what we want to do is first find it. So we are searching for a path, and the path has a fill, and we need to add another attribute. We are going to search for the color, and we have already picked up that color. So what you can do is when you have selected one, click on this eyedropper here, and then that color gets added. So select all of them and then deselect all of these here, like so. Okay, these are all selected. And then we can also replace. When you click in here, you've got all the symbols in the document. We're going to use the zebra. And of course, we want to scale them. And then we can replace them all. And there they are. So this plugin can find and replace, which is nice. But for finding objects, you can just use these categories and attributes. So everything that is in here, which is a lot, but if the shape of the object is actually all you have as a difference that sets the object apart, so maybe you have some shapes like these in your documents, and you have some other shapes like these, and you need to find this, then it can get difficult, and then you need to use the global edit, because that is the only function that can actually find by shape.